Welcome back to the Crooked Spine Show. When you're stressed, what do you do to alleviate that stress? Do you take medication? Do you drink, smoke, whatever it might be? What helps you relax, if there's another way to say that? In this talk, we talk about the benefits of motion, physical and mental benefits of motion, and how to start. In this talk, we talk about exactly what you feel when you feel relaxed or when you feel stressed. When you feel stressed, how does your body tense up? Does it cause headaches? Does it make you feel like you have a stomach ache? And things like that. And when you relax, what does that feel like too? Once you understand how your body reacts, everyone's body is different. Once you understand how your body reacts, you understand how to fix that to stay healthy in the long run. And this is more like long-term stress, not just a one-time type of thing. So we talk about also too, how does your body change chemically and hormonally when you have long-term stress in your life or your lifestyle? We talk about how it affects your cortisol, catecholamines, serotonin, endorphins. Those are your type of hormones that is affected by stress or when you're relaxed. Let's talk about your nervous system, how your nerves work in your body to cause you to feel what's called fight or flight, or when you're rest and relaxation for one, too. That's your sympathetic and parasympathetic system. Parasympathetic system, your stress response, and how that overall works in your body. Understanding that will help you understand how your body responds with symptoms you feel from those hormonal changes in your body, nervous system changes, too. We'll also talk about, too, how your joints are affected when you are not moving properly and how overall your body can be affected by the link of stress to a lack of motion. Putting it all together too, we talk about too, some of my patients actually go to these workshops so they understand already. When we move more, this is the key. When you move more, you stimulate the positive nervous system, the positive relaxation nervous system to make your hormones that affect your body to relax, improve and stimulate it more. So you have a better balance toward relaxation again with motion. So we need motion to make our actual body feel more relaxed. Whereas when we're stressed, problems when we're stressed, our body tells us not to move. It's gonna hurt more. This is a, if you want to call it a caveman or cavewoman type of instinct in our body. We haven't been able to fight that with motion to make our bodies feel better. In the end, we talk about certain ways to move, such as walking, individual joint motion from one to your ankle and wrist, along the shoulder motion, your hips and your lower back and hips, and also what do you want to do? And finding ways you can help your body routinely stretch. If you can stretch every day, work out every day if you can, helps your body go to bed at a zero, you want to call it stress level. So finding ways to do that is going to be up to you, but understanding your body is affected by stress physically, mentally, neurologically, and hormonally allows you to understand that you can keep yourself healthy when you move better. So do I talk to my friends? Again, links has shows to the video show notes along the workshop itself, along with the podcast, along with previous podcasts too, along with the outline of the actual show. So any questions at all? If not, have a great week, and we'll see you next week.
We're gonna move, right? We have to move. This is our talk, the benefits of motion, physical and mental, and also how to start. When we move, is it just our body being affected or also our brain being affected? Some people think yes, some people think no, some people don't know. I wanna help you understand how the nerves work to make your body feel good inside and outside, okay? It's not just watching good shows or good movies or funny shows. So number one thing is, who in here takes a shower or bath every day?
Oh, no.
Or jumps in the pool every day, right? Okay, when you take a shower or bath, how do you know if it's too hot or too cold? What do? I do this.
You feel it.
I touch it, right? What in my hand lets me know if it's hot or too hot or too cold? Nerve. Yes. Good. This is why you guys come to my class pretty often. You gotta learn something. If the nerves work properly, they'll let you know it's too hot, it's too cold. Those same nerves in your hand, for example, or on your skin, also are inside your joints, in your wrist, in your knee, in your ankle, in your spine. Your spine has 23 joints in the body. A lot has a high density of nerves. Thousands, millions, billions, trillions, if that's the word, I don't know. Okay, something like that. But it has all the nerves in there. So when we move properly, our body works to actually keep our body healthy and strong. Okay, we're gonna go through how that works, the details of it in a second. And again, I apologize for my drawings you'll see in a minute here. Okay, my drawings are not very artistic. You know, I have problems, but hopefully they're okay for you today. Okay.
Gives us a laugh.
That's all I'm hoping for. If I can entertain you, then you show up at the right place. It's all over, of course. Where'd my paper go? I lost my paper. Someone stole, hurry out there, stole my paper. Come on. The team's just giving, not taking.
Here it is.
I got a couple. Okay, so here. Right. We talked about a second ago is how the nerves are in our body, right? They affect parts of our body. They affect how we hear, how we see, everything that we that comes from our senses around us, our environment. Maybe hot, cold, what we hear, what we see, what we taste, all happens because our nerves connect with that, be it through air, through touch, whatever it might be. At that point, when they connect, they let your body know, hey, look, this is what it is. Or who knows what it is, let's find out what it is. So you want to make sure over time as you do things, you understand the nerves affect everything in our body. How does the nerves work? So we talked about a second ago, how we feel relaxed, how we feel stressed, is when we feel stressed, for example, how do we feel? What's our physical feeling when we feel stressed?
Terrible.
What's terrible mean though?
Anxiety.
Explicit. Anxiety, exactly. Okay. We feel anxiety. Okay. We feel tense. We can't sleep. We feel joint pain, feel back pain. We don't want to move when we're stressed. So we lack motion, so our body becomes sometimes more stressed. We'll go over exactly how it affects the hormones, how it affects your body internally too. When we're relaxed, how do we feel?
Relaxed.
You can breathe better. You can take deep breaths. You can sleep better, right? You feel like the muscles are just dropped. Okay, you feel like happier. You smile more often. You feel like the positive side of life, not the negative side of life. So it affects our body and mind together, both, right? Okay, how do we break that down? Our hormones can be positive or negative, okay? Just like anything else in our body. Hormones, here, the positive hormones, I'm gonna put positive meaning for me a happy face. Okay, keep it very simple. I learn and teach by third grade knowledge, is all I do. It's not very scientific sometimes, but it can be if you want to, you can watch that later. Positive are gonna be serotonin. Okay, what's another good positive hormone people may know? What's a good? Name them out there.
Endorphins.
Good. Endorphins. Okay, it's spelled P-H-I-N, people, not F-I-N-S. Okay? Other ones that are out there, you can name if you want to. Now, those are the basic ones, the major ones, that our body produces when you see a funny movie, when we move properly, when we get our body to actually feel good. Okay, so now let's talk about the negative hormones. These are the ones that cause stress in our body. Okay, such as catecholamines. And as I always say, there's no test at the end. Catecholamines. Okay, and also cortisol, big pain. Pain producer. Okay. So how do these hormones, how do they get activated, either positive or negative, by your nerves? If your nerves get your body to sense I'm under stress, my body becomes tense. I feel anxious or stressed in my head because now I've activated these catecholamines, cortisol more often. Okay. Cortisol. I don't want to put an S at the end. Cortisol's. Never mind. Okay, my grandfather, I got a C+ in science, so I follow English through my whole career of English study. So these things are activated when your nerves are activated. It can be temporary. Okay, boom, I see a scary movie. It's Halloween, right? I'm going to get scared. I sometimes scream in a movie theater. It's very embarrassing for me. Okay, but when that happens, that's one event. I walk out of theater, I forget about it, I'm good to go. When you're stressed all the time, maybe your lifestyle, an injury, a chronic injury, a chronic illness for one too. If you have something like that, your body can adjust to make these stress hormones more in balance for that favor. So if your body starts producing these stress hormones more than your happy hormones, at that point, how does it affect your body? What do we want to do? How does it go from here over here to where now this person... So going through this again too, part of what we're gonna do is how do we make these hormones, and how does that happen? How can hormones affect our heart? How, and take a step back, How does stress affect our heart? If our joints are moving properly, if my joints in my, for example, my knee, my back, my hip, my elbow, even my neck too, my foot, if they don't move enough, at that point, those joints send nerves to the brain to make that brain signals to your adrenals to produce more of these hormones.
So because, did you just say because you don't move enough?
Exactly. If these joints still won't move enough, if we have, this happens because of lack or lack thereof of joint motion. Okay? I'll just put motion abbreviated. Okay? So lack of joint motion makes these hormones become more sad hormones to make your body then, because hormones affect what? How does hormones get into your body? Excuse me?
Food?
No, not food. No. What part of our body circulates through the body the whole time? Blood. Okay? Where does blood go to in our body? Everywhere. Everywhere. So our blood carries hormones to every part of your body, every organ of your body, to make your body feel, from a hormonal level, when it's long term, more of a concern of overall feeling stressed in the heart, the lungs, the brain, your joints, everything. So it's a feedback loop. So when we have that happen, and the overall body stays under stress, then when we're under stress, do we want to move more or move less? Less. Less. Good. We're going to get there. But we initially, when we don't know what it is, we want to move less. I have patients come to my office, but in chronic pain, they have these hormones basically dominating their hormonal balance instead of the happy hormones. At that point, the overall body starts to get to where they feel stressed. They don't want to move. So what happens now, the feedback loop again is the body gets tighter. So it feeds these hormones because the body can't move enough. So our job is, and my job, is to let you know if you feel and you don't have an illness, an injury, or something that's more chronic to be careful with, we have to move more to get these hormones to rebalance themselves. A patient comes to my office, they're in chronic pain. Chronic pain for me is more than a month, usually, based on age and everything else too going on, their lifestyle. I always ask them, you've been pain for a while now, do you feel stressed? Sometimes it's yes. Do you feel like sometimes you're anxious because of the stress? Yes. You feel depressed? A 50-50. When they feel that anxiety, I'm going to let them know, hey, look, your body's in a stress state. Because of your hormone imbalances, we have to change this balance to better happy hormones by causing your body to move more. I'm a chiropractor, right? I move bones. By me helping move the bones, I'm affecting the body's hormonal levels, their nerve flow, getting the body to relax better. So I made someone that comes having with back pain or neck pain. I don't care about their pain initially. I go, I know you have back pain, I know you have neck pain, I know where it's coming from. I'm gonna treat that, but I want you sleeping better first. I want you feeling better here first, so I know we're causing a change neurologically. Because if you cause a change neurologically, again, these hormones are dropping, the stress hormones, increasing the happy hormones, your body's gonna feel better. Then you can work on stretching, exercising, and moving. But if the body is stressed, you're not gonna wanna move. So my job is to make sure you understand where it's coming from when you're in a stress state, a fight or flight state. Just get them out of there first by causing and injecting them, I'm gonna say, with nerve stimulation to get those better hormones moving by causing joint motion. That makes sense? If I move joints, I'm making those nerves stimulate the better hormones, so I'm giving them a quick boost of hope. And I tell them, I'm not a physical therapist, I'm not gonna stretch you out, I'm not gonna move things around that way. I'm gonna move just the joints. That point, I'm gonna move the joints, I'm gonna relieve the nerve pressure, causing this to happen. Then we'll talk about once you feel like I can sleep better, I can move a little better. Then I go, okay, now we're gonna add some stretches into your routine. We're gonna get these to stay here, like Sylvia mentioned a second ago. By now we know motion is gonna cause a better state of health, mental and physical. We're gonna get that to stay this way. That's the plan. Any questions about that? Yes.
I have multiple myeloma.
Yes.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Yep.
And what I do is just walk around the whole place.
That's you're reading my script already. Yep.
But that's all I do, and I feel relaxed when I do the walking.
Because you know.
Pardon?
Because you know already how it works.
But But the blood is the one that I have.
But you're making your whole body relax better by getting your body to actually feel the motion. Some people don't know that if motion causes your body to feel better, your whole system works. What's your autonomic system of your body? Nervous system. Nervous system has two things. Autonomic or automatic, and ones that you move on your own. Okay, automatic or autonomic is your heart. Okay, the nerves that go from your brain to your heart, to your lungs, to your organs. I can't stop my heart from, I can't manually make my heart stop. I'm not a magician. Right? Okay? So that's an automatic system in your body that works all the time. If your nerves are causing these type of hormones, at that point your systems start becoming more stressed also. If, for example, your bladder, okay? If you're under stress, what happens to your bladder? Does it constrict more or does it relax more? Constrict. Okay? I had a guy come in a couple years ago, only 25 years old, had a bad spinal injury, lower back, mechanic, something fell on him. At that point, he had so much nerve pinching, these were happening so much as sad hormones, he had gone urinated for 3 days. I said, oh, you're in the wrong place, buddy. Here's your x-rays, you're going right to San Antonio Hospital down the street and go talk to those guys. His girlfriend called me that afternoon, he's having surgery tonight. Because his system had been so cut off, his body had almost shut itself down. Talk about once you have urinary for a while, that's a toxic environment, the whole body shuts down, blah, blah. So you have to worry, it's a burn situation. You wanna make sure, wherever you are, how do you present that symptom of being either stressed or relaxed? At that point, like they're saying too, someone's been here for my classes, is how do we now move more to make these hormones become more dominant and get that balance back into play. Are we under stress every day? Yes. Positive, negative stress. Okay. Stress keeps our body alive. Stress keeps our muscles strong. I was talking to someone today. He was talking about astronauts. Why do astronauts have to exercise when they're in space? Why?
The gravity.
There's no gravity. Our body requires gravity to keep our bones dense, keep our muscles strong. So we have to fight gravity to make our body stay healthy. So movement keeps our body, like you mentioned, our mind and body healthy. Questions about my drawings, my wording? Anything makes sense so far? If I convinced you, have I convinced you, you can nod your head or not, motion is healthy because the nerves work better to produce more serotonin, more endorphins, happy hormones, and your stress hormones, cortisol, catecholamines, because your hormones are more balanced. If I convinced you. Yes, they were like, yeah, maybe, I don't know. I'll talk to you later. If you say no, yes, sir.
So when they give you drugs from this, what's there?
So when you give drugs such as a hormone, what happens, how does your body react to that drug, short-term, long-term?
Well, it's just addressing the stress of anxiety.
Mm-hmm. You're addressing this aspect, but you're not affecting everything else, so the whole system isn't working properly. You're just adding the hormone, for example, the hormone in, testosterone, for example, then the body goes, well, if you're adding it to it, I don't have producer anymore. It's called homeostasis. It's self-regulating system. If you give your body testosterone, that point your body regulates not to produce anymore. If you give your body other things that it has, that point it goes, I don't need to do it anymore. So by doing it artificially, maybe temporarily is good. If you go on through an illness, take the short-term thing, boom, not a problem. When you think about long-term hormone replacement therapy, okay, things that want to keep ourselves younger, longevity for one too, why not focus on what you can do naturally, if you can, and which we all can, then at that point you produce on your own, so now you need that, if you want to call it that, drug every month, every week, every day. That's a good question. All right, anything else? So if I'm not convinced you, okay, we're gonna walk through now, how do we get our body to move in simple ways? Yes, walking is number one. Who likes to walk? Good. Who likes to walk for exercise? Good. Okay. Walking allows your body to move better, gets the hips
the lower back, and even the neck, because you have to use your neck for balance when we're walking, to move. And those nerves in your neck, especially in your lower back, have a high density. Because they have a high density, they allow these happy hormones to stay them, to be more dominant, versus when those bad hormones get into your body more. So your body stays healthier physically, mentally, avoids long-term risk factors for Alzheimer's dementia. I saw a video on that today. It's truth. It's not just me talking about it. Yes?
So bring your blood pressure down.
Why?
Exercise and gets the blood going to all parts of your body, I guess.
Mm-hmm. You are correct.
If when I also had high blood pressure a couple days ago and I don't take the blood pressure medicine anymore. Mm-hmm. So got the high blood pressure. Took a banana, got on the bicycle for 10 minutes, at 128. Perfect. Get down to normal.
It's something to where people realize, okay, is the blood pressure an issue, or am I not? Can I do something to regulate it myself? Well, what most people that they just don't know, I call them naive. They haven't done their own, if you want to call it, search on how to do it on their own. They require that they, in their mind, they require medication, and they've been told you need the medication to keep your blood pressure down so you don't have a heart attack and a stroke and aneurysm and blah, blah, your hair will fall out, I don't know, okay? But something is, when you do on research, I even now the new thing is for medicine, that I heard last week, is because you're a candidate for high blood pressure, not meaning you have high blood pressure, we put medication now as a preventive measure to keep your blood pressure down if you have high blood pressure. How many pills do you want to take a day? People here are the healthy ones. You guys are the healthy ones. You guys want to learn. You want to move. You want to do things. Even though it's effort, you want to do the right things to stay healthy as long as you can. Why do you want to stay healthy when we get older? When we're, I won't say wiser. Why do we want to stay healthy? What's the reason? Live longer, yes. What else?
Be active.
But why though? Why?
Be able to be normal.
Mobility, independence.
Get out and enjoy.
Yes, Sylvia.
I don't want to be a burden to my family.
Independence, mobility, physical, mental. As long as we can, again, we can hit by a bus tomorrow.
Yeah.
If it's quick, I go, thank you very much. Thank you, if it's quick. Take me, please. Take me, please. Take me today. Take me down. But if it's not going to be quick, let's do whatever we can to stay healthy so we're not burdening our family, physical and financial. Okay? And I know so many people that take care of their elderly parents, and it is a time and mental burden, which they would do every day of the week. But can we prevent that from happening by keeping ourselves healthy? By not taking medication we don't need to, by doing the right things to get our blood pressure down, keep our cholesterol down, keep our body moving better. So these things here allow us to work better. Okay, so we talked about walking already. Okay, we all can walk, we all should walk. When I say walk, I had a younger mom. I told her, hey, let's start walking more because she's been inactive because of COVID. She's been home all the time with the kids. Because, yeah, I go walking. I go to Target, to the Walmart.
Well, there is walking there.
Walking, by definition, moving your feet, yes. Walking for exercise is walking at a constant pace for 20 or 30 minutes. Every other day, maybe. Okay? That's walking. You guys are there. We've got 24. That point, that's walking to get your body strong, get your body moving, so that constant motion, those nerves continue to fire. It's not walking going, oh, I bought a purse here, I bought some rings here, I'm like, great, here's a credit card payment again. No! Keep your credit card bill down, please. Next one. Not yet. I'm dumping it down on the water bottle. Okay. Next one. Can we move while we're sitting? Yes, we can. We take our body and here move our ankles. I'm watching football and I'm like, my team's the worst team in the world again every year. So could we take this and just move our ankles slowly in circles? Maybe 10 directions one way and 10 directions the other way. You can do a figure eight if you want, or like count to 10 or something, I don't know. But can we move our body? Because ankles, like the hip, like the back, like the neck, there's so much load on your ankle, it has to have a lot of nerves. It's where all your body weight sits on your ankle when you walk. So move them allow that joint, the send signals from your foot, from your ankle, to your knee, to your hip, to your back, to your head, to your brain, keep your body happy. Figure eights, one leg, yes.
I do a lot of Spanish dancing.
Urban, yep, I remember, yeah. Yep, fantastic.
Your head, your arms,
this is it. And your legs. If you can get there, fantastic.
Yeah, that's what I do.
Do you break dance too?
No.
I'm going to show you some moves. Show me some moves if you can, okay? But again, simple things you can do during commercial, when you're at home, reading a book, you read a book. I can't multitask. I'd read a book, I'd like, okay, let's go with my ankle over there. It'd be hard for me to do it. That's just me. I'm a specialist. But once you move things around, once you realize, okay, I don't have to walk every day, I don't have to exercise every day, go out and do something, I can do it at home. But it's consistency is going to be your goal to keep these hormones down. Because again, our body's under stress every day. We have to fight that not loving feeling to make our body stay healthy. Can I get those innuendo there? I'll make sure you got it. Okay. Now, wrist motion. All right, these are my famous water bottles I bring everywhere. Okay. These are one's Kirkland. I don't know how I got two different ones. Okay. But these here, take your water bottle, and here at your arms or your sides, just again turn your wrists. Simple. Turn them. There's four different motions of the wrist. Turn them and also flexion extension. Still this way.
But not too many. If you have arthritis.
Why?
The bone pong bonus.
Irritating. But you want to move the joint though.
I had a problem.
You want to overdo it. You want to feel the motion but not the pain.
I did arthritis teacher training.
Yeah.
Four if you have arthritis in that area. If you do more, it's going to start.
And everyone's different, right? So feel where you're comfortable with. When you're uncomfortable, okay, stop. And start over again. And then once you've done this long enough too, if that feels good to you, then, okay, this is complicated, so make sure you watch this is a complicated one. Then from here, you can do now, once you've done the wrist ones, do this. Arms out. Oh, your shoulders now. Simple things. Okay, rotate your arms too. And if you want to, just hold them one way, hold them the other way. Be creative, unlike me. Okay? Simple things again. Don't have to go everywhere all the time. Just because most people think, I have to go to a gym 5 days a week. I have to go at this at a certain time. This class is only at 12 o'clock on a Wednesday once a month. I have to go to that class. It's doing things all the time. Consistency again. Okay? I'm a morning person. I work out in the morning and my stretch is done first before I leave for the house. I'm consistent 5 days a week. But that's me. Some people like to work at night. By 9 o'clock, I'm done. Put me to bed. Okay? Put me to bed at 9 o'clock. Okay? Next one is pelvic tilts. Okay, so if I'm sitting again, everyone sits, right? I sit. Can I get my body to lean back a little bit, hold that position, and then do more of a hunch with your lower back and tilt forward. And see that, see your body feel that stretch in your back. And feel your hips here, even stretch in the front too. We need to move enough and just hold that, say, for 5 seconds, then switch positions, 5 seconds here. Simple things we can do to keep our body active and moving, keep our joints moving so the nerves work better, make our body stay happy. Again, all comes back to that. So tilt one way, 5 seconds, other way, 5 seconds. Okay? If you're watching a TV show, how long commercials normally? 20 minutes, an hour, right? Oh my God, I forget what I was watching. Listen again, I don't know what I'm watching anymore. But just 5 seconds and 5 seconds back. I go 3 to 4 times. Keep it very simple. Okay. Next one is basically whatever you want to do. So if you want to do one even in bed too, which I was going to show also here. Tilt this down a little bit so I can still see myself. Here and then here is taking, if I'm in bed or on the floor on a mat, whatever you want to do, is even with your hips, get your hips to shift a little bit like this. Here in bed, bring one leg up, bring your hip out, hip in, extend your knee and let your leg drop flat. Same thing here, left leg now, knee up, foot's off the ground, bring your knee out to your side. At that point, bring it back in and leg flat. Repeat that. Now bring your right leg up here,
that point, knee to your chest or close to your chest, knee out to the side, bring it back, and keep your leg bent, and just keep repeating it. That point here, out, left leg to the side, back in, and then also foot down, okay? These are some things you get. It doesn't require a lot of weight, it doesn't require a lot of things, just motion, movement, time, consistency. How many minutes a day do you think you should stretch or move? You talk about 30 every other day for walking, right? How about motion in your body? Your back, your hips, your knees, your ankles, your shoulders. How long do you think you should do?
I mean, for stretching, about 5 minutes.
I like, if anything, if you want to add them out throughout the day, anywhere from 10 to 20 minutes.
Range of motion? Or?
Range of motion, okay. Just 20 motion.
20 minutes for range 20, of motion?
10 to 20 minutes. Yeah. Okay, if you aim for 20, hit 10, you're just a loser.
I can't help you.
But to where we have to move enough again to see that. Have a good day. To see that improvement. You know, we have to move enough. And I tell my patients the same thing too. I tell my patients, because I want them to go through rehab and get the idea of forming a habit, it takes 3 to 4 weeks minimum, and that's minimum, 3 to 4 weeks minimum, to form a habit. For your body to change this balance back to normal from a hap, from a sad or stress hormones, the happy hormones, takes 4 to 6 weeks minimum. Your body has adapted, making this your normal. You have to readapt to a better normal. All right? Any questions at all? How many days a week should you work? Should you stretch or move your body?
Every day.
Every day. I tell my patients, days end with why. Focus on those days end with why, you'll be fine. Which is? Every day. Okay? Again, it's just finding a time for you throughout the day that works for you. I like the morning before the phone goes off, or the kids get up, or the dog gets up. I get all my stretches done so I don't have to do anything else. I check it off my list. I may do it again at night, depends out how sore I am from working out. When you do these simple things, these are just simple ones, but do what you like to do. The best workout is whatever you like to do. Maybe walk, maybe moving joints. If I'm going to walk, am I still moving my upper body? Yeah, you are, but do other things too. Once you start doing something, you go. The best things I hear when they've turned the corner is, what else can I do? Boom, I got them. They formed the basic habit. Now they want to add to that because they're getting bored. Perfect. That's why I know they want to get better. When they miss a day of working out, they miss it tomorrow, just working, I'm like, perfect. It's their habit, not their routine. You have to find a routine and maintain that. Again, what's coming up next, couple months?
Christmas,
yeah,
Thanksgiving.
Yeah, Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, New Year's, all the food. For me, all the tamales, all the turkey, all the prime rib, hopefully this year, get prime rib this year. You know, all the good stuff that make, and even routines, right? We have to go visit this family, we have to go do this. We have this we have to do now. So your weekends or your weekdays are thrown off. So by having a consistent habit now, I mean not to be 100% on it during the holidays, we want to make sure we have something going to next year, so we're not going, I should have not gained 10 pounds this Christmas. I lost my whole habits. I'm going to start over in January again. Oh, start it now. Be the above average. Get your body to stay healthy through the holidays and the rest of your life. You know? How long do we have? I have no idea. But can we do as long as we can? Any questions? Nothing? Simple things. Again, most of my thoughts, yes.
I have an idea.
Yeah.
When you're walking, mm-hmm. we can take our weights with us mm-hmm. and do the weights while we're walking.
Some people do. I see my uncle all the time using weights. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Again, it's modifying for you. Taking one weight, one arm one time, switch sides, one arm one time. Boom. You know? Someone tries to attack you, just throw the weight at them. And weapon too.
Good idea.
Yes. No.
Especially the dogs.
Use a stick, whatever you want to use. But that's the thing, is find ways to do this. Again, my other lectures, my other talks, role especially, are about how to low back exercise, neck exercises, shoulder exercises. I walk through a lot of exercises. This is more about why we should move, how we move, and why it affects our overall body, mind, and body, not just because our joint feels weak or strong. All right? Questions? Or in the fence.
There was a research done with walking real fast, you know, mm-hmm. or running. They used on mentally ill people who are highly sedated mm-hmm. and a lot of drugs. their drugs, once they start running in the morning, I don't know how long.
Probably 30 minutes.
Half hour or an hour.
Yeah.
Their drugs was cut in half.
Oh. How's that work? Does your doctor tell you to go for a walk, go exercise, try a routine?
I tell
you. Usually not. So how do we make our body, how do we not listen to, even me, listen to your body, what it requires? This is just physiology. If you're a human, if you're a mammal, if you're an animal, it requires this to stay healthy. No matter what your name is, who, how old you are, anything. It's everything. Anything else? Questions? Answers? Yes.
Can you stretch your neck muscles?
Exactly. One thing you can for the neck stretch, I showed before too, bring your, so you're going to stretch your right side, and your left hand behind your right ear. Let your head turn to your right shoulder, and from there, let your arm drag your head down toward your body. There we go. Right there. And real slow. Hold that for 30 seconds on both sides. Gets that upper area, you loosen it up. And just to hold for 30 seconds. It's just the weight of your arm. So I use the weight of your arm. Go. Little things. We do every, I do in all my class all the time. Neck pain, boom, that's our number one thing. But we have to keep our body loose and strong. So when we have an injury, recover a lot faster too. Again, get off medication if we can.
Stress is probably giving
me
a pain in the neck.
It is. Everyone holds stress. Everyone, and everyone's body's different, right? Everyone, that's one thing. Everyone's body's different. So some people hold their stress in their neck and shoulders, some in their back, some in their knee, some in their, I have wrist elbow pain. I go, what's going on? What's your life so like? I'm pretty stressed. Okay, let's just change something else. We're on. Let's get things loosened up. You gotta figure out how your body works for you. All right? Next month, too, remember, next month, I'm doing it. I'm going to be on vacation. I'll be in Hawaii, so I can't see you guys until the 23rd. 23rd of November is my next talk instead of the week before. So you can make it that 23rd of November before Thanksgiving. Cool? I'll be here. Or if not, you can set on the notes, too. You can always go to my YouTube to see the day afterwards, where I post a video of this workshop the day afterwards.
It says you're going to do it on wheelchairs, though. I don't know.
It's, I think that one
that's
is.
What it says.
Does it say?
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah.
So on that one, it's supposed to be chair, walker, and wheelchair.
So if you have one, if not, what I'm going to modify that for is if sitting exercises also. Sitting and standing exercises.
You sit too much.
So sitting exercise will help move those hips and joints and lower back. So how do we make, if we're sitting in anything, it doesn't matter if you're in a wheelchair or a walker or chair. Is how do you make these hips, this back looser so we can stand more? We can slowly, if possible, get out of a wheelchair and get our body moving better. Again, we don't want to be a burden to our family or ourselves. So we want to make sure we move better. All right? Anything else? Good to go? Keep moving, my friends. Have a good day. I'll see you guys next month. And the video will be up this evening on my YouTube channel on the bottom of the page. All right, have a good day.
Thank you.